sang the Marwa Church Choir. Marwa Church Choir, as they are receding, can we please invite the Ohanze District Choir, Ohanze Seventh-day Adventist Church Choir, and that will be Marwa Farm District. Thank you. Thank you. Beautiful music. We are grateful. Please, Ohanze, you should be walking up to us now. Otherwise, we will take another choir before you. Directly after Ohanze, we will do a short documentary. It seems to me that Ohanze Church Choir is not here. And in their absence, can we please invite the Itungwa Church Choir? Itungwa Church Choir, could you please come? And let's take you shortly before the documentary. Please, if we invite you, you make haste to be here because I know you also need to also get home quickly. As they are filing out, you'll be filing it. It makes for continuity, and that is what will require this moment. We're trying to manage our time so that everybody will be satisfied. Ladies and gentlemen, that's Ohanze. Ohanze District, you're welcome. Please be reminded that you are restricted to just one song amongst the many that you have prepared, so that others will also have a chance. Thank you for coming to this program, and the Lord will bless you as you minister to us in songs. Responsible for a short documentary that is put it up. Thank you. And the district. And district Uri Amela. Abu Mbarebe.
I was always with her. fact, I can say that she died in my mother's life. Mama was all I had. She took care of me. Whenever she discovered that I'm not happy, I could see in her face that Mama would not be happy.
The story of the life of Mrs. Bessie Ibazo is an interesting one. She was born on the 7th of May 1928. Her parents were Mr. Wangu Anaba and Mrs. Mabel Wangu of Umuafo village in Obinwa local government area of Abia State. She had two brothers, but both of them died at infancy. Thus, she grew up an only child. Growing up as an only child in her family was a bit lonely for Bessie, but her parents showered her with love. In 1944, when Bessie turned 16, a tragic but very significant event happened. She lost her father, and the world seemed to come to an end for Bessie. But God had other plans. Bessie's mother, Mabel, was a unique woman in many ways. She did not allow the death of her husband to ruin her family, but quickly stepped into the gap.
In the morning, I was a very old idiot for that line of my bed. I'm not going to put that hand down, my bro. I'm a very, very remarkable woman. And when they have gone through my first tricycle, who they have also reacted upon. Definitely, we're going to find the car, I'm going to get there. And that's my grandmother, but I'm going to go then.
Because Bessie was 16 years already, her uncles arranged to give her away in marriage, a development her mother resisted. Mabel believed that anyone who did not have a good education would have to struggle to survive, and she did not want that for her only surviving child. She ran away with young Bessie to her own village, Obakiri, where she lived and raised Bessie. Thus, in 1945, at the age of 17, Bessie started elementary school at the Adventist School, Aba. Her mother struggled to educate her and see her through professional training at the School of Nursing, Adventist College, Ile-Ife, now in Osun State. Mabel sent money to her daughter at Ile-Ife monthly for her upkeep and school fees. Sweetheart, Mr. Ishmael Kulanya Ibazo, in December of 1961. The marriage was blessed with 3 children. They are Okezie Victor Ibazo, who is the current governor of Abia State. Okezie Edith Uwaja, who took after her mother and went into the medical field. And Ihanichukwu Ugonna Ibazo, a barrister at law.
When I became a mother and started having my own children, I realized the magnitude of sacrifice that my mother made. My mother worked full-time at the hospital, and she ran her clinic in the evenings. And there was time that we were sick, that
family mourned the exit of their mother. They didn't mourn with hope that when Christ would come again, all of us would meet their mother in eternity. To the church here, a pillar has come. We pray that God will bless you from the beginning of the rising into the glory of God. Come here, but I'm sure that I will serve our God in the step of God.
Could you please put your hands together for Mama Abia Nebesi? And that was the life and times of a mother that sheltered all ensemble. We'll be asking Itungwa Church Choir to please proceed to the podium, and that will be the last choir we'll be taking this evening. We shortly before announcements will be taken, and His Excellency, Governor of Ekiti State, the special guest of our governor, Dr. Okezie Ibazo, and all the distinguished ladies and gentlemen that are here present, who will be listening to our dear governor in a short remark. And the official part of this program will be brought to an end. The church journey, ala, denge for now for. I'm going to go to the church. Honorable Commissioner for Works, Honorable Sir Giovanni, to come near the podium. I will request Honorable Commissioner for Works, Honorable Sir Giovanni, to please come near the podium. Ladies and gentlemen, in the next 11 minutes, the formal part of this program will be brought to an end, and the informal one that will continue till morning will begin.
I'm not going to be able to do that.
Ladies and gentlemen, all the security men to please gather around the front of the governor's house. There are challenges that you need to deal with. Please, the detachment of security men should go near where Suya is being prepared. There will be some challenges that you will need to respond to. Please, only one man, wherever you are, come closer to the podium to speak with the commissioner for information. Security men, please go near where the Suya is being prepared. There are some gentlemen that might need some attention. Please, only one man, wherever you are, come closer to the podium as we invite the Honorable Commissioner for Works, Honorable Nathan Chokani, to please rise up to the podium and make the necessary remarks. Honorable Nathan Chokani, please come to the podium.
Good evening. Our governor, Dr. Kesi Bazi, Excellency, the governor of Ekiti State, the one and only Ayo Fayose, members of National Assembly, especially our senator. I've also seen Senator Adolphus Wabara, former Senate President, our party chairman, Senator Mamaka, the chairman of the party in the Southeast, Colonel Akobondo, as well as many other people. My name is Ezu Chupani. I have a few announcements to make. And that concerns the job of ensuring that we have a seamless ceremony tomorrow. I'm standing on behalf of the chairman of the Central Working Committee, the Deputy Governor of Abia State, Right Honorable Udo Okotchukwu, and he has directed me to make the announcement. We have done well for today by the grace of God. And we pray and hope that the same grace of God will lead us to have a very successful burial tomorrow. Our mother lived a very peaceful life, was a very peaceful person. And it is our prayer and wish that tomorrow will be very peaceful and very successful. Concerning tomorrow, because of the number of people that we expect, we have designed a few innovative ways of managing human and vehicular traffic, and it is as follows. If you come from this area, please try not to drive to this venue tomorrow. The venue is very compact, and we may find it very difficult to manage vehicles and human beings tomorrow. So if your vehicles we have here, it'd be better for us to manage the ceremony. So as much as possible, try to leave your vehicles at home. What we have designed to do is to move people into this venue, to post them here in transit buses. We have designed a few car parks out of this venue, beginning from Itumba Secondary School. There's a car park there. There's also a car park at Itungwa Primary School. there's another car park at Umuobiakwa there, the new square that's just been excavated just close to this place. We expect that the property designated by the protocol people, we expect that when you arrive in those places, then buses will convey you to this venue. That also goes for people coming from Aba, beginning from Umuakata or primary school.
That thing needs to stop.
Please, if you love the governor and the family, do not create problems for them.
What you say,
if the security and protocol people ask you to stay down from your car and get into those buses, please, we exhort you to do so in the name of God. We're very peaceful and I know you're going to comply as a tribute.
It's running on the other program.
To this very peaceful and loving woman who touched a lot of lives around here beyond.
So you are on another line?
Yes.
The other thing concerns the people who have been managing this ceremony. I have the permission of the deputy governor to announce to you that all members of the central working committee, members of the subcommittees, as well as members of the LOC, will meet on the other side of this hall immediately after the ceremony. We need to kick off our activities for tomorrow. The other thing would be if you have driven into this venue and for any reason do not leave as you're leaving, please drive your vehicles away. The reasons we're saying that is because we have to manage very high people in society and then we have to deal with their security. So move your vehicles away. If you leave your vehicles in this arena, by the time you wake up in the morning, they will be in Aba. The members of the Abia State Traffic Management Agency, members of Aba Urban Renewal, as well as other agencies are at hand to take them away and keep them in safety for you in Aba. Definitely, there's no parking lot here, so move your cars away. I implore you in the name of God. The other thing is, we have designated the old centers appropriately. They will conduct you to where you're supposed to sit tomorrow. There are places you're not supposed to walk around or move around. Please, if they tell you not to walk across those lawns, please do so. We are very hospitable people. Abia is very, very hospitable. And people are beginning to love Abia State. Please do not put a fly in the ointment. If you're asked to do anything tomorrow, please do so peacefully and quietly. Show the new face of Abia to the people who are coming from Abuja, from Maiduguri, from Sokoto, and from all over the world. Thank you. I know you comply. The other thing would be between Itungwa and Umuakata one, as much as possible, there will be no traffic. There are alternative routes. You can go through Itungwa and get to Osa, and from there get to Ohoro and Obikabia. You can also go through Owo and get to Ohanze. You come out to Obikabia, so we know the routes. If you're going between Aba and Omwaya tomorrow, please, as much as possible, go through the express. Go through the Enugu Port Harcourt Expressway. Make a say, for another fire that's you. Oh, my man, I'm not going to talk about it. That is the end of my announcement. I have been told to invite my boss, the governor of Abia State, to come and speak to people of God. I then thank the people, thank his people. I then assure you that the family will continue to fly the flag of that Ibazo iconic family. My governor, please can you step to the podium and say one or two things to people?
because I've lost my voice. Probably because I have so many crowded thoughts about this woman that every attempt I've made in the past to piece issues together by any specific logic has failed. So I prefer to keep my sanity and watch as we change the things in center stage. I thank God that when my father died, I had the voice to speak. But I suddenly lost that voice. And therefore, in the spirit of democracy and 30% for women, I yield to Ocheze this moment, even till tomorrow. But, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, brethren, it is my honor and privilege to, as part of the authority of a governor, I can make proclamations and it will come to pass. I have chosen this day to change the order of protocol because of reason of respect. For the fact that he is somebody that has won election twice as governor in this country. And because I know he is far more experienced than myself, who is a baby governor, as it were, quote and unquote. I yield part of my authority to the executive governor of Ekiti State, His Excellency Ayofayose Oshokomole. Please, sir, come and talk to my people. Thank you very much for coming. Your presence here have made my body lighter. And I feel stronger and better prepared to face tomorrow as an old man. My brother, my friend, and my colleague, the people of the state, and
Your Excellency, the Governor of Abia State, our leaders present, like you said, taking protocols one after the other, we will not leave here. But you know, I have great respect for you, particularly the good people of Abia State that has loved this family, especially unto the departure of our beloved mother. Bible says it's appointed unto a man who wants to die. Someday we will go, whether we like it or not. And this, among other things, has given me great courage. Because the Bible says, what shall separate us from the love of God? Is it death? Is it hunger? Is it illegal detention? Is it, you understand what I'm talking about? You will recall that this is a very solemn night. I want to leave it solemn. The other ones will continue after the event. You know, and I know, that Igbo people are people with very great resolve, strong character people. People believe in hard work. Call them any name, they believe in what they believe. The most traveled, you find them in the remotest village in this country and beyond. I genuinely, sincerely love Igbo people. And my last son is called Chukwuemeka. Tonight, I am pleased. pleased to be here. I got to Abuja, I thought this occasion would be next week. So I got to know this at the PDP Governors Forum last night. And I realized my brother had visited my state twice. I will not go back without coming here. And I don't want to be late tomorrow. I decided to come tonight. It's a great pleasure for me. He introduced me as one governor that has won election twice. That introduction is not correct. I've won elections by defeating two incumbent governors at two different attempts. I'm the first Ekiti son to be governor twice. And I don't want to talk about my CV tonight, but I want you to know that the best for you and I is yet to come. I told him when I was in Dubai, when I had ridiculous judgment, tell your enemies back to sender. Tell your enemy back to sender. Again, tell your enemy, tell that judgment was for the court of appeal back to sender. I will be here at the celebration of the Supreme Court with you. Whatever God gives, he does not take back. And no man can take it back. I am not afraid of what men will do to me because I have Christ. I am a man of faith. Telling somebody I will take you to prison and so what? I was in Ikoyi prison for 45 days, charged to court by EFCC, detained my wife for 33 days. They took me to court. I defeated them everywhere. I got judgment against them for harassing my wife. I got 10 million naira judgment. So fear not. We will celebrate you very soon. I say we will celebrate you very soon. You see, you said my name is Oshokomole. That is the only one you know. In my state, they call me one lady number. Abuni Chamber. Lion guiding town. We will guide this place together. You will guide this place for very long. The Lord will be with you. You see, I don't know my man. But the Englishman says, show me your friend and I will tell you who you are. But I will tell you in another version about this mama and his son and the other sibling. When you don't know the manufacturer of a product, you can tell by the product itself. This is the product. This death is honorable for this woman. This is the time to go. For your son to be so exalted, at this time, Mama departed. She has departed to glory. You know, I don't pray my mother too should die now. I don't pray like that. But this departure is glorious. All this woman has left behind will not go back. You are a symbol. You brought all of us to this community. I've never been to Aba before. In my history, I will tell of my visit to Aba. I want to leave you in the hand of the Most High God that is able to keep the body and the soul to eternity. We will meet Mama again at the feet of the Lord Jesus Christ. Once again, I congratulate you and your family and the people of this community for being alive at Mama's departure. God bless you and see you tomorrow. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, as we invite Pastor, Bani to say the benediction, we will request that all choirs that are present in this ceremony will rise so that shortly after the prayer, the Alleluia chorus will be sung by all the choirs in unison.
Shall we please rise? Let us rise and close our eyes and thank our Heavenly Father. Shall we pray, please? Our Heavenly Father, we thank you. We thank you for what you have done here tonight. Things have been done decently and in order. May your name be praised. Daddy, your people are about going. You brought us safely. May you also take us home safely. For tomorrow's event, take preeminence. Let everything that will transpire tomorrow bring glory to your name and blessing to your people, especially the Ipazo family. Thank you, Father, for we know you will do more than we can ever imagine or pray for, because we pray it all in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you. Shut it. I've come later. Thank you.